Okay, welcome class to HPE. Today we're going to be learning about the fundamental movement skill of kicking. This is a soccer ball. Can someone please put their hand up and give me an example of a sport that uses kicking of the ball? Yes? Yep, that's right, AFL, good. Any other ones? Yeah, rugby, they do kick the ball in rugby. They punt the ball, well done. Anything else? Yes, American football, they also kick the ball. What about this ball here? What's this ball used for? Soccer, correct, good answers. Okay, all these are great answers, and kicking in sports requires our arms or our legs, you tell me. Our legs, that's right. So what we're gonna need to do to begin the lesson, we're gonna warm up our legs before we get down to learning the skills of kicking the ball. So let's do it.
I want you to jog one lap around the playing surface and return and form small circles of four students, and then I will give you further instructions. So everyone, go for a run around the playing surface. Go for it. Come back and form groups of four. Let's go. Okay, so you've all formed your groups of four. That's great to see. Now, I want you to grab a hold of your friend's hand next to you in your groups of four, and I want you to begin to balance on one foot, like I'm doing now, on one foot, and begin to kick with the opposite foot. Balancing, moving the foot backwards, 90 degrees, and forwards and through. And once you feel confident with one foot, I want you to change feet and begin to swing through your other foot and find out which feels easier for you. Are you better at balancing on your left or your right foot? Go for it. Okay, everyone stop and listen to me. Listen to my voice. Okay, class, we're going to participate now in a second activity that will test our skills of control. Now, in soccer, why do you think you're going to need to have control of this ball on the ground? Why would you need control? Yep, good answers. Because if you don't control, it might fly out of bounds. Excellent, that's right. Or the other team might get the ball. So we need to learn to have control when we are dribbling the ball. Everyone say dribbling. Very good. Also, we're going to learn how to do foot passing. Everyone say foot passing. Okay, we're going to be practicing that skill. And we're also going to be practicing the skill of trapping the ball. Everyone say trapping. We're going to trap the ball. Good. So I'm going to give you numbers now from 1 and 2, the number 1 or the number 2, and I want you to go where I tell you. Number 1s, I want you to go and stand on the line after you've grabbed a ball from the equipment bag over there. One soccer ball, don't move yet. Grab a ball, go and stand on the line after you've been given a number. Number 2s, I want you to fill this playing space and become statues. Now don't all gather together, I want you to spread out number 2s across the playing space with your legs apart like this, like a statue. Can you see I'm a statue? I'm not moving. I look kind of like a soccer ball, don't I? I wonder what's going to happen for the statues. All right, so let's count you off. Number 1, number 2.
Okay, you're in place, now listen to me. The first skill in soccer is dribbling with control. Look at the ball, can you see? I'm not gonna kick it hard, I'm just gonna dribble and keep it close to my feet. Keeping it close by, moving around, changing direction, dribbling the ball. If I kick it too hard, the ball runs away. I wanna bring it back, and I want to dribble that ball with control. The next skill we need to learn is foot passing, which looks like this. When you foot pass, you will often kick on the side of the foot. So it's a small little punt, it's not a hard kick, but it's a small pass like this, okay? Let me show you that again. This is a foot pass. Foot pass. One more time. Foot pass. The next skill, which you may have already observed, is trapping the ball. Trapping the ball means that you are going to stand on the ball while it is in motion to stop it moving. So if I show you again the foot pass, watch what I do after the ball is in motion and I want to make it Then I'm going to foot pass through the legs of the person and trap the ball on the other side of the person. Did you see how I kick the ball through their legs? Through the legs of the statue. Now, statue, stay still. Don't move. This is learning how to control the soccer ball in play. So let's start with dribbling. Watch me again, and then it's your turn. Dribbling the ball, coming towards the statue, foot pass around the statue, and trapping the ball on the other side, and returning and going and finding another statue. Okay, go for it. So I need you to stop and leave your ball right where you are standing. You are now becoming statues. Statues, I want you to find the ball. You are now becoming dribblers. We're swapping over. It's your turn now. Statues to become dribblers and learn to control the ball, making sure your dribbling is in control, as I've shown you, that you're able to foot pass that ball through a statue's legs and trap on the other side. Good luck. Go for it. Stop where you are. People who have the ball, I want you to put the balls back in the kick bag over here where you found them originally, and I want everyone to line up along the line as you were lined up at the beginning of the lesson, waiting for my instructions. We now come to the most fundamental, crucial part of the lesson, and this is learning how to strike the ball, how to kick the ball at the goal, essentially, to win those goals and to win a game. Without goals, you can't win a game of soccer. And so this skill is fundamental to the game. Now, the first step is eyes focused on the ball. Everyone say, eyes focused on the ball. The next fundamental movement in kicking is a forward and sideward swing of the arm opposite to the kicking leg. Forward and sideward swing of the arm. Can you see this arm? It's opposite to my kicking leg. There we are. As my leg comes forward, my opposite arm moves in the opposite direction. Next step is your non-kicking foot. In my case, that's my left foot because I kick with my right, is beside the ball. Here it is, beside the ball. When I'm going to kick, my foot that's not kicking the ball should be lined up beside the ball. Step four of kicking. We need to bend our knee that is kicking the ball at least 90 degrees backwards during the backswing. So I want you to stand, put your arm forward on the opposite side, bending that knee, your kicking leg back at least 90 degrees backwards. You can see that that's a 90 degrees angle there between my two legs. For ready for kicking, 90 degrees backwards. Go for it. Step five in our fundamental movement skills of kicking the ball, we want to contact the ball with the top of the foot. Now, we did learn about foot passes this way, but in striking, generally we're going to kick the ball on our shoelaces. Can you see my shoelaces there? The top of the foot is going to contact the ball when I kick it, and that's going to make it go very fast. And the final step in kicking successfully, the kicking leg follows through high towards the target area. So if my target is straight ahead, which it will be, the goal, my kicking leg is going to follow through high towards the target area. Okay, now I need you to verbally recite the steps that we've just learned. Copy me. After I say it, you say it too. Ready? Step one, eyes focused on the ball. Say it. Step two. Okay, great kicking, everybody. I want you to all gather around here, put the balls back in the bag, and come sit down, and we're going to have a little chat about next week's lesson. Great skills today. I can really see you're achieving great things. You're following through with those six steps, that motion that it requires to kick successfully. And at the start, you showed very good control, foot passing, and also trapping. So you are well on the way to learning how to be great soccer players.